Hello and welcome to this solo playthrough of Mephisto the card game. I'm just going to play through a single game in the solitaire mode, and I'm not going to explain all the rules, but this will be more of just kind of a playthrough to get an idea of what it plays like. You'll notice I'm using the program Tabletop Simulator, and this is mainly for ease of recording, but a couple things about it. Normally we would be using this favor like our reminder card to track our favor. We'd be sliding that up and down, but it's a little fiddly in here, so instead we're going to use this counter to track our favor. With that said, we can go ahead and start. So we set up the same way, shuffle the deck, and then we will add cards to the dungeon. So let's go ahead and fill that up. Oops. And for the starting round, we ignore the immediate effects on any monsters. So normally these will trigger whenever they come out into the dungeon, but for the setup, we can ignore that. Start with three cards in hand. And then for our first turn, we will draw a card. All right, we've got a lot of spells in our hand, but that's not too bad because these are all decent spells. So I think our first goal is going to be to try to take down this vampire. And a good way to do that might be to use this blast wand because it's going to trigger off of these spells. So for our first turn, I don't think I'm going to play anything here, but I will loot. So we're going to use the loot action, which means we're just going to draw any non-monster card from the dungeon, put it in our hand, and that's our action for the turn. So what happens in the solitaire game is after you pass your turn, but before you refill cards in the dungeon, you're gonna discard the top card of the deck. So in this case, it is an item. And whatever card type that this is, you're gonna discard a card of the matching card type from the dungeon. So this is an item, that means we're gonna have to discard an item from the dungeon. So this potion will go away. And this is basically a way to cause the dungeon to continue moving. After you've done that, then you can go ahead and refill cards from the dungeon. And you'll notice this has an immediate effect, which will cause each player to repair one, but we don't have anything to repair, so in this case, it's not going to do anything. Okay, so our next turn, we'll draw a card. We got a monster. Well, I think we could do our plan of Blast Wand, and there's a chance we could even get enough attack to kill this guy. So let's go ahead and play the Blast Wand here. The Blast Wand costs one, meaning we have to discard one other card from our hand. We have two skeletons, so we can definitely get rid of one there. And then I think we want to. I think we're just going to illuminate because this will get us four favor plus the three here. So we mostly just want to play a spell. So let's go ahead and illuminate. So what that does is it replaces a lane. Let's see this lane. And these cards go on the bottom of the deck. And then we gain four favor. That also pumps up this, so this has a total of six. And we're going to use it to fight the spider, which we need two more, so we can spend two favor to defeat the spider. All right, that's our turn. Let's go ahead and flip the top card. It's an item. So if there's no cards matching that card type, you just discard the next top card instead. Oh, and our goal in the solitaire game is to try to get to 16 soul points as quickly as possible, and then the amount of remaining cards in the deck will determine our score. So we're trying to get to 16 and then just see how much is left. All right, so now we got to refill. This Doominate will trigger, we're going to repair that. All right, and we draw a card. Cool, we have a lot of spell shenanigans. So think our best bet, we should probably just play out the Soul Feeder. Although we can play that next turn, so that would give us 5, 8. I have a better idea. If I summon the skeleton, let's do that. I'm going to summon the skeleton. So to summon, you replace a card in the dungeon with a monster in your hand, and then you gain 3 favor as a result. So I'm going to gain 1, 2, 3. I put that skeleton out there, and I grabbed the blazing that was there. All right, now we flip. Okay, so now if you reveal a monster during your opponent's turn, instead of discarding the highest cost monster, it's going to replace it. So in this case, there's actually 2 tied for highest, which means we get to decide where it goes. So let's actually do that Doom Knight over there. All right, now we take our turn. And we got another spell.